Chris here, and welcome back to what was requested a lot, and that is DaVinci Resolve. I've got the latest version, 17, on both of these units right here. So the MacBook Pro 16-inch model that I've got is the base model, okay? So 512 gigabytes of storage, 16 gigabytes of RAM, and the M1 Pro. 10 cores for the CPU, 16 for the GPU. Up against what has been my editing machine for 4K video, this is my MSI GE66 Raider. Now, this has the 4K OLED screen, which is great color coverage with this one. It's 100% Adobe RGB, which actually betters out this one, but it's only 60 hertz. Of course, this is ProMotion, 120 hertz, but we've got the RTX 3080 on board with this too as well. So this is a powerful gaming laptop. How is it going to compare with this even test here with just taking a look at the performance in DaVinci Resolve and then the export times of both of these? Now, to point out here that both of these systems are running on AC power, MagSafe is connected. They both have the latest firmware updates. Still on Windows 10 here. I haven't converted over to Windows 11, so that's not really going to matter anyway, okay? So they've both had a fresh reboot too, so there's nothing running in the background. There's no silly Windows updates going on, and both really up to date there and good. So what I'll do first is launch DaVinci Resolve at the same time just to check on the performance. Now, it's DaVinci Resolve here, version 17 that I'm running, so the latest for the M1 support. So here we go. Let's do this at the same time. So I've got to double tap and just time this. There we go. All right. So clearly the MacBook M1 Pro pulled ahead there. Very quick to load that. But sometimes I have noticed that with the M1 Pro, the initial first loads of applications can be terribly slow. And you sometimes second guess yourself and go, actually, did I load it? So spot the difference. Can you pick up on it? What is going on here with the colors of the video? Only the video. With the MacBook Pro here, so it looks fine on the Windows PC, okay? So the MSI is looking good, the GE66. The phone that I'm holding is orange. It's not yellow, it's yellow here, and my face looks green. Now, this is something to do with my Sony A6400 files, because I had this exact same problem in Adobe Premiere Pro. So it's not related to these programs, but it's the OS itself. So I don't know what is going on, why this is happening here, but it's a software related bug that, of course, Apple needs to fix. So that, if I go and look at this actual clip now, outside of the program, it's not going to show up all orange and funny and yellow. So let's have a look at the tabs here. So going over to the edit tab, look how quick that loads in. Now I'll do the same, go over to edit here from the cut tab, and see how that video is taking a little bit longer to load in. It's like this throughout. Just the overall performance of that M1 Pro Apple Silicon here is just doing so much better. So if I go over now into, this is on the Windows PC, just over to the different tabs, loading those in, I clicked and you can see how long that took to come in there, okay? So I'll do the same now with this. So that's the Fusion tab, okay? Pretty quick. And color, that was laggy on the Windows 10 PC. So clicking that, look at that, it's instantaneous. And this is just throughout, all right? I could go on and on and show you even more of this, but all of the tabs, all the editing, everything I do, timelines. Okay, but look at that, actually, a little bit of the timeline here in edit. Everywhere is just so much better, the overall performance. And I have the settings on both of these all set to 4K for the project. So that's the preview, that's the export that I'll be doing shortly now, just to show you the speed of that. But by far, hands down, the M1 Pro here, impressive performance, just editing, very basic edits that I'm doing here, by the way. You can see the standout difference now compared to the Windows 10 PC. So if I go over back to the edit tab here and show you the timeline with this one, it's a little bit laggy, okay? You can see that I'm trying to go as fast as possible, and it's slowing down. This is with an RTX 3080 and that Core i7. And it's getting even choppier. Look, that's just general performance. It's so noticeable. The M1 Pro is just walking all over the Intel and Windows 10 PC. So I'm back in now the cut tab, and I just want to go to the quick export option, which is right there at the top. Okay, a little hard to see. This is the preset I'm going to go with, is the YouTube one that I want. Okay, so YouTube, and I do have there UHD, okay, that's selected there, and it is 30 frames per second duration, 17 minutes, 56 seconds on the Windows PC. Now, I'm not going to hit export just yet. I want to do them both at the same time, but let's go over to the Mac now. And you can see here the same exact settings, so that's UHD, 17 minutes 56 seconds at just shy of 30 frames per second, the YouTube preset. Time is right down here, and I will hit start just after I hit the export at the same time here, and it'll give us a rough idea what we can expect performance wise. So just lining this up, export and export. Okay, let's do this at the same time. 1, 2, 3. Okay, and of course I need to save. All right, timeline, that's going to be onto the desktop right here. Save as timeline 1. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, we'll do that at the same time as well. Save. There we go. We are away, and the timer, whoops, that was about 2 second delay there. Okay, 1 minute in, and the Windows 10 PC here is reporting 38 minutes remaining with the RTX 3080. And let's look over at the Mac now. To 1 minute 44 in, and 8 minutes remaining on the Mac only. Look at that difference. And just looking at the Windows 10 PC, it's still reporting, well, 38 minutes. And this is now under 8 minutes. Wow. Wow. That is so quick. It just shows you when that M1 Pro is optimized with the same exact software, massive differences here. Now, the other factor to definitely consider is, what about heat and fan noise? Well, right now I can hear that my gaming laptop here with the RTX 3080 is getting a bit loud. And I'll give you a sample of it right now. Just hold up my mic to it, which is a lav mic. The M1 Pro powered MacBook Pro 16 inch version is making no noise. If I hold a mic up to it, you're going to hear the noise from that MSI GE66. So it's just getting, it's barely even warm to the touch there at the top. And yeah, that's getting pretty hot now, the top of that MSI gaming laptop. Just over 5 minutes in, and we're looking at 33 minutes remaining on the Windows 10 PC. And we just have now 4 minutes and 30 seconds, just under, with the MacBook. Now, what you do want to focus on is the render speed, which is always about 52 frames per second on the MacBook Pro here. And then with our Core i7 11th Gen 11800H, around bouncing between 18 frames per second and sometimes 20, 21 frames per second with the rendering speed. Ouch, that's a huge difference there. We are talking over double performance on that M1 Pro versus the RTX 3080 gaming laptop. So here we go, the MacBook is finishing up. Remember, this is the M1 Pro version. Sorry, I do not have the M1 Max. That would probably be even quicker. So what time is it gonna do it in? The 18 minutes to the 4K YouTube preset. There we go, 10 minutes. Okay, so it only took 10 minutes to encode an 18 minute clip there. Meanwhile, looking at my PC here running Windows 10, that still needs another 22 minutes. And I am seriously about to fall asleep waiting for this to finish. 18 seconds left, but take a look there at the render speed, what's happening on the Intel here, that MSI GE66, down to 14, 15 frames per second. So it is about to finish up. Oh, I've got 6 seconds left and 34 minutes here. Oh, that's crazy. So there we go, it has done 34 minutes and 34 seconds versus just shy of 10 minutes on the M1 Pro powered MacBook Pro 16 inch model. Wow, massive difference. And just very quickly to touch on that issue that I have with the colors of my video, only in these editing applications looking all strange. A lot of people came to me and said that, hey, check your color profile. Is it not set to be correct here? Is it the Spider Pro 5's color profile interfering? Well, I've actually got it closed now and I'm not running it. Maybe it is the Spider 5 Pro that's affecting the colors, making it look wrong, but it's just the video clips, which is really weird because the rest of it, everything else, if you have a look, everything else, the colors look correct. There's nothing wrong with that. It's only the video. So something to do with just the videos being affected. If it was Spider 5 Pro, it would also affect the whole screen, or the color profile would be the whole screen. So I believe it's a Apple bug, because it cannot possibly be, well, I don't think it could be, Apple and also Blackmagic with their DaVinci Resolve both having the same weird color issue. And then that exported video, when I play it, the colors are correct. Otherwise, this would look yellow, my face would be all orange, guys, and you can see it works.
For the last week, that is Vivo's top dog, the X7.
Now, that was completely unexpected. I double-checked everything. I looked to make sure that, yes, I exported at the same preset. Yes, it was the same. I'm just blown away by the fact that this took 10 minutes to do 18 minutes of footage in DaVinci Resolve. And then this one, 34 minutes. Wow, I would never have thought that, okay? I'm a Windows PC guy, and I can clearly see now that if you use DaVinci Resolve, you want to get a Mac. You really do. You want to get the Apple Silicon. You want to get a M1 or M1 Pro or the M1 Max. Really, it's that simple, because the performance, not only just the export times, but the performance in the timelines and the editing tab and the color grading, you saw as I swapped between them, as I switched, everything would just load in almost instantaneously on the M1, where this would be like chugging away, even though it's got PCIe 4, a Samsung 980 Pro in this model here, and the RTX 3080. Made absolutely no difference. I'm mind blown here. That's just wow. So there we go. If you want to see Geekbench Cinebench R23 and a 3D Mark test, then check out my first video where I did an apples to oranges comparison like this video. So thank you for watching. Do subscribe for more upcoming videos from me. And if I can get my hands on the M1 Max version of this model or the 14-inch one, I will certainly do a similar benchmark, comparison here.